welcome back the Day of the Dead. It's coming alive at a local restaurant, Cuchara Restaurant, a local Mexican bistro. We're serving up a little something special for guests this holiday. And here to give us a sneak peek as to what you can expect at Cuchara, we have owner Ana Beaven. Thank you for coming in.
Thank you for having us.
Okay, Day of the Dead going on, and you guys have some special treats and a special event. I want to start first with something that you guys are doing very, very special called Soca Wheel.
Yeah.
That's close, right?
Very close. Soca Wheel is a really big tamal. It can be made of pork or chicken. In the old era, it was supposed to be made of humans. So, of course, we go for the pork.
I appreciate you changing it to something else.
We go for the pork and the chicken. Unfortunately, that is such a big tamal. It's probably up to 7 feet big. So we brought something similar, which is a tamal costeño. You're very welcome to try it. This one has pork and a little bit of spices.
It's really good. So going in.
We brought the spoons and we brought the corn of that we used to make that.
So it's like the traditional tamale, just a little bit bigger.
That's correct.
And you guys, I'm sure, are getting ready for the holiday season to go over and above beyond on tamale making.
Yes, exactly. We have about over 100 tamales that we prepare. And a lot of different things we do with masa. So we're going to try another thing with masa, a drink.
I'm trying a drink?
You're going to try a drink.
Okay.
And Onfalia is going to demonstrate the tortillas that she makes. Onfalia is from Michoacán. So in Michoacán, they have a very cultural experience when they do tortillas. So she makes 4 different kinds of masa. The reason why you see the masa has different colors is because we use fresh ingredients.
So the ingredients are what are giving it the color.
The masa, yeah, correct.
So then the dark kind of purplish color, that would be what?
That would be black beans. Black beans with a dark corn from Michoacán. Then this one has pepper with cilantro, guajillo, and this is just like our plain one.
Okay.
So she puts the 4 little spoons and then she makes a tortilla.
So is there a trick to rolling out the masa?
trust me, there is a crazy trick.
Can you show me what's the trick?
Azuna. You should go ahead and
wait a little bit.
Yeah.
So a little bit, okay. So just a little bit, right?
Mm-hmm.
A little bit more.
Yeah.
Nope. Perfect size there. Okay.
Yeah. This one.
Right there.
Yeah.
And the green, which is again the pepper.
Mm-hmm.
So the green would be more the bell pepper, correct?
Uh huh.
And then the red, I'm gonna assume, is a little bit on the spicy side.
It's not that spicy. You're gonna like it.
But the. And I love this press. This is an old-fashioned press.
Falia wouldn't take my job offer if she didn't come from Michoacán with her tortilla press.
Do I need to hold or anything?
No, just
hold it.
Oh, please.
Now open it. Please look pretty. Awesome. Looks good enough to eat.
Love it. It is amazing. So you should take one and eat it. We brought a little bit of salt. This is salt that we serve at the restaurant. It's 90% less sodium than the usual salt.
Really?
It's made of rain, believe it or not. It's from a receptacle in Yucatan where
I love
water just filters them and then it becomes salty. So you have to try it.
Okay.
Get a